In order for us to accurately understand and apply the scripture to our lives, we must first understand it within the backdrop of when it was written. Now, I want to teach you four steps. It's a four-step process that will help you accurately understand and interpret scripture by drawing out the true meaning, not what we think the meaning is, and to discover what the author originally intended to communicate to his audience. This four-step process is commonly referred to as exegetical or inductive study, and it includes four sections of four steps: observation, interpretation, correlation, and application. So let's take one at a time. First of all, there's observation, and it's basically observing the text. By doing this, it will answer the question, what does the passage say? Now, here are some tips on how to observe the portion of scripture. First of all, I really want to encourage you to read the text not just once, but multiple times. You may even want to pull up a Bible app and listen to it. When you hear it audibly, it has a different flow and meaning to it that's brought out through the actual voice versus the written. Let repetition be your friend. Consider printing out the verses on a sheet of paper if you don't want to mark up your Bible. I do this all the time. It allows me enough space to be able to write the questions that I have, because I promise you, you will have questions. But stick to the facts as you're reading the text. Write down the details. Avoid personalizing at this point, or elaborating or paraphrasing. Look for the five W's and the H: who, what, when, where, why, and how. See if there are any contrasting or comparison words or phrases. And if you see words and phrases that are being repeated over and over again, that's key that the author is trying to make a point. Make note of a certain type of day if it's mentioned, or a day of the week, or a season. Notice geographical locations and find them on your map. If something jumps out on the page, make note of it. Look for specific actions and responses from the people or God in the text. Consider reading the passages in other translations to bring clarity. I do this all the time, and it helps me tremendously. You might want to look up unfamiliar words in the dictionary. I always keep a dictionary with me when I'm studying scripture. And if you've been studying scripture for quite some time, you may want to consider using a Greek and Hebrew dictionary for better accuracy. My favorite site is blueletterbible.org, and it has everything that I need to look at the original root word in the text. Here's the key. Take your time. Be curious. Write down your questions. Delight in the details. Step number two is interpretation. Interpretation answers the question, what does the passage mean? Now, here are some tips that you can use when trying to interpret the text. Now, I want to tell you, resist the temptation of combing through your Bible study notes and commentaries. I used to do this all the time. I would read the passage and I'd go straight to the notes at the bottom of the page. I'd think to myself, why spend time looking it up for myself when it's already given to me right there? But give yourself permission to think objectively. Be willing to wrestle well with the passage instead of settling for secondhand revelation, sort of like I did, from someone else who's already done the work for you. Consider summarizing or rewriting the passage in your own words while keeping in mind the author's original intent. Remember, that is key. Try to see through the lens of Christ first. Don't self-define with your own meaning. Review the facts that you've already written down in your observation section, and then ask yourself these questions. What is the significance of the passage? What did the author intend to communicate to his original audience? What is the spiritual lesson or principle? Is there a tension that needs to be managed? Is there a promise that I can claim? Is there a command that I need to obey? Is there a correction to pay careful attention to? At this point, you might want to consider using cross-reference verses that pertain to the passage. You can find them in your study Bible notes right in the center. And then ask yourself, as you look up these other verses and you come up with your best interpretation, ask yourself, is my interpretation consistent or is it contrary to the other Bible verses on the same topic? Let the passage speak for itself. Don't try to twist the meaning. Scripture always interprets Scripture, and I promise you it will be your best commentary. But keep asking questions. Come up with your best interpretations. Step number 3 is correlation. Correlation answers the question, how does a passage relate to the rest of the Bible? How does this passage connect to the grand story or the meta-narrative of Scripture? Do you remember what those 4 points were? It was creation, fall, redemption, and restoration. Ask yourself, how does the passage that I'm reading or the chapter that I'm studying relate to the sections that have come before it and follow behind it? Now, I will tell you that this step can be challenging if you're new to Bible study, but don't get discouraged. Be okay if your answers aren't always correct on the first try. Over time and with additional study, this step will get easier. Step number 4 is application. Application answers the question, what does a passage mean to me? I call this one the now what step. So now that I know these truths that I've studied, now that I've observed the text, I've given it my best interpretations, I've figured out the correlation, now how can I practically apply all these things that I've learned to my life? So here are some of the questions that you can ask for the application step. What do I believe is the main thing that God is saying to me in this passage? Another question is, how does the passage change my understanding of Him? How should it change the way that I live and interact with God and others? Maybe ask, what do I have in common with the characters in the passage? Or how can these truths change my perspective on life and my current circumstances? Here's one. What is the central truth in this passage that I need to put into practice today? Or what should I do differently in response to what I've learned? This 4-step process will help you accurately understand God's Word so that we can apply His truth and His promises to our daily life situations. And you know what? In a nutshell, this is how we gain wisdom. We take God's Word and we understand it, and then we apply it to our lives. Now, after you've gone through these steps and you've wrestled well with the text, then you can look to other Bible study notes and commentaries. Commentaries will either confirm what you've discovered in your personal study time, or they won't, and they can help clarify some of your questions. Be sure to look for similarities and consistencies between those commentaries and scholars. And always remember that Scripture alone is inerrant and will always be your most reliable source. Be sure to share what you're learning with others. I love to collaborate with friends when I'm doing Bible study, after I've finished my quiet time. You know, it's fun, and studying in community really helps me grow in my faith as I'm encouraging others around me. Now, I put together a sample teaching of Mark 14, 3 through 9 that outlines this 4-step process of observation, interpretation, correlation, and application. And you'll find it in your workbook along with some of my notations. This same story, which is Jesus being anointed in Bethany, is also found in Matthew 26, 6 through 13, and John 12, 1 through 8. I want to encourage you to practice it this week, while these steps are fresh in your mind. Read these other verses and go through the 4-step process of exegetical study, then compare it to the sample that I've put together for you in the workbook. I promise you, you will be amazed at how much more you'll learn that will shed light in this incredible story of Jesus when you compare the different stories in the Gospels.